I know that this show has been a series of finales, but finally we are close to the real one. But before we do that, I'd like to reintroduce Mr. Stevie Wonder.
You know, I've experienced in my life, recent times, so many great experiences. Tonight, having a chance to perform with, again, Mary Wells, Martha Reeves, the Four Tops, and having the pleasure of performing for the first time with Gregory Hines, Patti LaBelle, the New Jersey Mass Choir, Rod Stewart, Diana Ross, again, Sarah Vaughan, Sammy Davis, I mean, Boy George, George Michael's are just incredible, and I really want to thank all of the performers. Smokey. I want to thank everybody for allowing me that great privilege. You know, when I first appeared here at the Apollo on stage at the age of 11, the future looked almost too fantastical. Things like, would little Stevie Wonder become a grown-up wonder? Would technology ever use its capability to bridge a gap for handicapped people? Would hunger, homelessness, racism, and senseless hatred always exist? Well, Motown is still paying me, so I guess that I can consider that a wonder. All of the equipment that you see can be programmed by anyone, sighted or blind, to play by itself. That is a technological wonder. But if these things have become a reality, these fantastical things, why are people still hungry? Why are people still homeless? Why do we still hate? Why does there now exist a new word in our vocabulary, apartheid? Why do we as writers and artists have to still write and perform songs that let us know that love is still starving for itself? Maybe if we are as committed as those people who have given their lives for love and living our lives to love, songs like this song might become someday obsolete. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. George Michael.
Good morning, friends. Here's your friendly announcer. I have serious news to pass on to everybody. What I'm about to say could mean the world's disaster, could turn your joy and laughter into tears and pain. It's that love today. Don't delay, send yours in right away. Hate's going wrong, breaking many hearts. Stop it, please, before it's gone too. And it will if we let it destroy everything. precautionary measures. If love and peace you treasure, then you heal me.
I'd like to thank Motown, the Apollo Theater, the ghosts and the greats who have gone before, the stars who have returned to recapture the wonder of it all, and all those who will have the honor of playing here in the future and keeping the legend alive. And thanks also to the audience here and all across the world who gave us good as they got. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Diana Ross.
This room, wow, it's been more than 20 years since we performed here. It was 1963, a tape I saw today. Anyway, I'm happy to be here. I rushed a long ways. I hope you've had a good time.
I want you to show me. mansion, the other in a suburb. Stephanie Powers as identical twins with nothing.